Now, the championship day of TV's all-time favorites on Family Feud. The Brady Bunch family versus the Petticoat Junction family. The finish of the fight. Introducing for today's Feud, the Brady Bunch family. Florence Henderson, Robert Reed, Susan Olson, Christopher Knight, and Maureen McCormick. Reunited again, ready for action. Competing against the Petticoat Junction family. Frank Cady, Linda K. Henning, Lori Saunders, Gunilla Hutton, and Meredith McRae. As they are today, on your marks, let's play the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Johnson.
Today, $10,000 at stake. So far, playing for the House Ear Institute, the Brady Bunch won $5,788. At a Goat Junction, playing for the Cerebral Palsy Foundation, $10,805. The big one right now, today, make them feel at home, the Brady Bunch.
How are you, Angel?
Richard, on behalf of my family, I want to tell you this has been one of the most fun weeks we've ever had.
You're
well,
here.
Thank you.
Just
we've
fabulous.
Had a great time having you here,
you're
and I really
great.
Mean it.
You're great, and all your crew is great.
Thank you. Well, good staff, good crew. Thank you very much. Let's meet everybody.
Okay, I want you to meet, I think, one of the finest actors that we have in America today.
I agree with
I mean
you.
That very sincerely. Holy. I'm proud to call him my husband and my friend, Mr. Robert Reed.
Yep.
Welcome, Robert. Good to have you here.
This is Susan Olson, who was Cindy on the Brady Bunch.
Pretty Susan. Welcome.
And this young man, I think you're going to hear from, I think he's going to become a tremendous star. He's great, and he's a wonderful
wow.
kid. Christopher
nice.
Knight, who was Peter. And dear Maureen McCormick, who's a friend of mine and a very talented young lady, and I wish her well. She's getting married this summer.
Bride-to-be. Yeah. Sweet okay. Maureen. You're a very, very special lady. I've known you a long time, and...
Yes.
I've always treasured you as a
thank
friend,
you.
And I thank you for
give
being here.
Give my love to your boys.
Okay. Okay. Hey, I thank you for being here.
No, it's
you
been my pleasure.
Here. So I'll pick you up right after the show.
Okay, could don't you? Tell him.
Fine, I'll be wearing a carnation. How are you?
How am I doing compared to Ken?
Ken we had on, Ken Schreiner from General Hospital. We just presented him the Einstein Award compared to your answer. A decision that changes everybody's life. You went, BAM! The money decision.
That's
right.
A
we still have no idea the what the hell decision. That meant.
But I'm still working on it.
Very good game. You don't
thank
have
you.
To worry. Here's our bride-to-be. August?
August, yes.
Take a long time.
Come on, Maureen.
Got a black
come
stand
on.
There? You got $100.
Come on, Mo.
Do it again.
Two, isn't it? Two for you? Yes, two. Here they are, the Petticoat Junction folks.
They're all in the game anyway.
Got over 10 grand.
Isn't that nice?
Let's meet everybody.
This is Linda K. Henning, who played Betty Jo Bradley on our show.
And beat her, I believe. Welcome.
Lori Saunders, who played Bobby Joe.
Hey, Lori.
Billy Joe, Gunilla Hutton. And again, Billy Joel, Meredith McRae.
Hey, Allison's mom. I thank you for being here. I'm going to miss you all because you were a marvelous player.
Thank you.
That's what we've always
from,
said.
From the Little Butterflies that started, you got over 10 grand already.
Oh, it's wonderful. Oh. Thank
really
you.
Really is.
So much fun to win.
I was only thinking about that as I looked at you, honey. Yeah. Canola, my favorite flavor. Thank you.
We've had fun, Richard.
You played well, too.
Thank you.
And here's the love. Like, I've known Meredith.
Oh, yes. Many, many moons.
This is sickening.
You're really good.
Thank you.
Even though he says it's sickening. This one's for $10,000.
Right.
Who's going to win? Let's play it.
Good
luck. 100 people
Richard,
surveyed, top
Richard,
five answers.
Forgot my lollipop again.
I did that again, didn't I? Well, I
get, forgot it.
I kiss you and get involved.
Forgot
take one
it yesterday, and you forgot it again today.
Grab it.
All right.
Good luck, Meredith. Okay.
Come on.
Do it for Allison.
Aww.
Meredith? Yeah. See, that's why I forget. You can't pick a lollipop to save your life, honey. You've got two lollipops there worth 11 cents. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. When a wife really flatters her husband, what bad news is she preparing him for?
She spent too much money shopping.
She has spent too much money. Very good. One answer will beat it. What do you think it is, Frank?
She smashed up the car.
Wrecked the car. What are you going to do?
We're going to play.
Yeah.
You bet.
Yeah.
Okay. Play. All right. When a wife really flatters her husband, what bad news is she preparing him for? I'll do this also in French. Ça convient de ce que tu fais, l'homme, ça compte du bassin, bon de l'air.
I'm really confused.
I'll do it in German. The Hausfrau destroyed my heim. Excuse me.
Okay, I give up,
All right.
This could be bad news. I mean, it would be normally good news, but for some it could be bad that she's pregnant.
Well, sure, it could be bad, you know. Okay. Let me take a look. Particularly if he's had a vasectomy.
Okay. His in-laws are coming to stay for
a week. Wonderful, Lori.
In-laws.
That was a good one. That's a good one. That she's had an affair. That's pretty bad news.
Yeah. Waste of time flattering him, really, but we'll take a look. All of the money for the fat.
Oh.
Have to be very flattering for him to buy that.
Oh, I was thinking along the lines of Gunilla. I can't get out of my head that she wants a divorce. But why would she flatter him? But that's all I can think of.
Well, maybe so that he will be reasonable about it instead of the cross.
Maybe. Yes, I love you, but I want a divorce.
That's it.
Yeah. That's probably it.
That's good.
I'd like a divorce, please.
One more.
Oh, Frank,
any
come on,
idea?
Frank.
I was hoping you wouldn't get to me.
Well, it's...
Since you're here.
Yes.
She's unable to balance the checkbook.
That's good. Well, that's very good. She's overdrawn the checking account. I cannot believe that we will return. 99 Petticoat. Brady Nutman. Robert. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you know you do too much of for your own good. Roberto.
Drink.
Drink. Two answers will beat it, ladies and gentlemen.
Eat too much.
Eat. Mangiare.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Yeah.
La, la, la. What do you do too much of for your own good?
Stay up too late.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
Stay up too late. It's not affecting you. You know.
Well, I stopped, but I guess for a lot of people it'd be smoke too many cigarettes.
That's a goodie.
Yeah. That's a good one.
Smoke! Yeah. And I'm very proud that you stopped. I mean, you know, you do too much alcohol.
I don't drink it, but a lot of people do. They drink too much coffee.
Coffee?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Coffee!
All right.
Oh. Right.
Oh, here you are again.
Yeah. Yeah. It works out now.
Watch television.
Mm-hmm.
You're on good? Too much.
Too much.
Is there all right? If not, third strike, TV, watch it. Gonna get in this game, are we?
Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
This is, I think we decided that this is...
Oh,
what?
Can I sit
there? Did you say it right now?
Yeah, it's something that I suffer from. It's talking too much.
Fioronga, too much Fioronga. Talk too much. Six.
Give any points
April, for that? Love. We'll be back right after this. 99, Petticoat. Brady, 75. You got a game? Come on, man. Come
on, Susie.
100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Many churches are named after saints. Name one. Yeah.
St. Francis.
St. Francis.
St. Joseph.
St. Joseph. Play it back.
Play it. Play. It's okay, Susie. We'll do it.
We'll get him.
St. John.
Okay. St. John.
I would say St. Patrick.
Oh, God bless you now. St. Patrick. Yeah. It's a nice way to treat saints, actually. Start from the bottom and gradually get to the big saint when we left. What saint church is named it?
St. Paul.
St. Paul.
St. Paul.
We know that in England. St. Paul.
What everybody wears, usually wears around the neck, St. Christopher medal.
Exactly.
Yeah,
Christopher.
That's a good one.
St. Christopher. No. No good for churches or medals.
We have no medal.
St. Thomas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. St. Thomas.
This one better work. St. James.
St. James. I know they have some infirmaries. We'll take a look. St. James. No.
We got it.
Give me one of them. You've got the $42.
Oh, please, please let this be right. Please, the most famous church of all, St. Peter's.
St. Peter's. Yeah. If it's there, you get the $42.
Oh, please
if
be
not,
there, please.
Petticoat does. Hey, Peter.
Please.
Yeah. St. Mary. The bells of St. Maclovio, 117 to 99. Let's go.
Money.
Come on, Chris.
Come on, Villa. Yeah.
Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something men want most when they come home after a hard day. Christopher.
Food.
Food. Yeah. Well done.
Yeah, I'm getting better, huh?
Man, what does he want most when he comes home after a hard day? Give me an answer.
Sex.
there.
You
know, you are just getting married, aren't you? It's after an easy day you want
that. Okay, Maureen, you keep doing that and your marriage will last a long time.
But you'll be a very early widow, buddy. Something men want most when they come home after a hard day.
I know a lot of men enjoy a good drink.
Okay, my love, a drink, a good one. You got it. Let's go.
I'm torn between two. I think I'm going to go with shower.
Thank you.
Or bath.
Don't ever. Don't ever string us out like that. Shower!
Come on,
yes, my darling.
Okay, how about a good pipe or smoke?
Okay, my love. If it's there, all right. If not, third strike, a good pipe. No. Two answers remain. Frank.
What have we got? We haven't decided yet. We're
come
not
on.
Ready. To be left alone would be one thing.
The thing men want most when they come home after a hard day. Give me an answer.
Please be quiet. Please be
to hear the news.
To hear the news, all right. To hear the news.
What?
Peace and quiet.
Well, we'll take a look. Three.
He left alone.
Right.
I didn't have
four.
Conversation.
Ten. Peace and quiet was their other answer. Find a little peace and you hope. 271. 99. Let's go. Wish each other luck now. This will decide who'll play for the $10,000. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you spread on bread.
Yeah. Butter.
Butter. What are you going to do?
We're going to play.
We're going to play. All right.
Okay.
Right.
Jam.
Jam. 3 seconds, sweetheart.
Peanut butter.
Peanut butter. 3 seconds, sweet Laurie.
Sugar.
Sugar. 3 seconds.
Mayonnaise.
Mayo's there. You're the champs, and we'll play for $10,000. Mayo. Stay here. Leave them on. They're not. Thank you. Who's not that? Come on. Who's first? Good to get married. They're the playing for $10,000. Oh. Allison's mom, Meredith. Cerebral palsy left. $10,000 at stake. 15 seconds, please. Tell me how long it takes to lose 10 pounds.
2 weeks.
A state where it's hot.
Arizona.
A beverage you drink every day.
Coffee.
A comfortable piece of furniture.
Couch.
A national credit card.
Chevron.
Turn around. How long it takes to lose 10 pounds? You said 2 weeks. Survey said? 27. State where's Arizona. Survey? Beverage you drink every day. Mocha. Survey? Comfortable piece of furniture. You said couch. Survey said. Okay. National credit card. Chevron. Survey said.
Oh.
Where are you? 110? Is it better than the
phone? All right, I'll wait over here.
Off you go. We're looking for Linda Kay. Look at this. 110, you need 90. You can do it. You know we love you, and you go win the money here. Please remind everyone the answers Meredith gave us and give us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Tell me how long it takes to lose 10 pounds.
A month.
A state where it's hot.
Florida.
A beverage you drink every day.
Milk.
A comfortable piece of furniture.
Couch.
Try again.
Easy chair.
A national credit card.
Master charge.
Okay. Good job. How long it takes to lose 10 pounds? You said a month.
Takes
number
me
one
that
answer.
Long. Oh,
number
really?
Oh, good. Sorry, said. There it is. State where it's hot. You said Florida, number one. Woo. Survey said.
Wow.
Beverage you drink every day. Water was number one. You said milk. Survey said.
No.
13. You got 180. Comfortable piece of furniture. Bed was number one. You said chair, easy chair. We need 20 points for $10,000. Survey said.
Oh.
National credit card, Bank America or Visa, number one. You said Master charge. 3 points?
Gotta be worth three.
For $10,000. Survey said. First of all, your hit parade came. They won about $200. We made it $1,000. You played for, if I recall, Pet Orphans, right?
Right.
I like even numbers. I'm going to give you $1,500. Oh, my buddy, the Beaver, and everybody came from Leave It to Beaver. They played the Footlighters, which was a very special, I know, charity for you. They won $5,425. Let's make that $6,000. Yeah. I love to hear the Brady Bunch. Got right up into the finals. Played for the House Ear Institute, a magnificent organization that I know helped you with your hearing, helped me and a lot of other people. $6,430. I know Dr. House likes even number checks.
$7,000.
Oh. Yeah. That's a chance of our very first week. Playing for the cerebral palsy. They won $21,195. We'll call it, as we say in the business, $22,000. The champ, Petticoat Junction. There's your trophy. You were just superb. I thank you. I thank you. You were a delight, really. Next week, we got Batman. Playing Gilligan's Island versus Lost in Space and Hawaii and I. We love you. We'll see you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. And Mark Goodson, Television Productions.